Well, here I am, back at the Farm of the Good Food. Do you recognize this spot? I filmed a video at this spot already. The only difference is I was 14 feet lower last time, and we had just finished tearing down the fence in preparation for this structure here. This is a calving shed, a luxury, expensive, two-stall calving shed that they've been building here, and I raced back from the Eschpeter farm so I could film them putting the finishing touches on the roof up there. I didn't quite make it, I arrived just after sunset, but luckily they weren't finished putting the plywood on the roof, so I was able to film some of that the next day, and even stick around and put some screws in myself. So I can say that I helped build this thing. And that kind of got me thinking. I mean, so much of the day-to-day life of farming since I've gotten here in Alberta hasn't really been about raising grain or raising cattle. It's been about building and maintaining things like this calving shed, building infrastructure. Or check this out, this is at the Eschpeter farm. Isn't that incredible? That storage bin's got to be 30 feet tall and he's towing it with a tractor. But this is the day-to-day life at the farm. This is farming. And I guess it's got me thinking, well, you know, what's the point of all this infrastructure? I mean, it's just a calving shed. Doesn't seem like that big a deal. Or it's just a fence, or it's just a storage bin. But, I mean, you think about the storage bin. If he didn't have the storage bin, his crop would come off the fields all at once. And he'd have to get rid of it right away when everyone else on the prairies is trying to get rid of it. So, aside from just being a safe place to put grain, I guess you can kind of look at it as an investment. That storage bin enables him to sell the grain when he feels like he needs to sell it. And I guess it helps him make money that way. That's ultimately why it's worth putting some money into a storage bin. Or this calving shed. This calving shed will help protect the cows and maybe save a calf's life when it's 30 below. But I guess this just helps show me that there's so much more to farming than, you know, the romantic scatter the seeds on the ground and harvest them, you know. A lot of the day-to-day is building things, maintaining things. And I don't know, that's interesting to me. Anyway, this week I learned the difference between straw and hay. And you can see both types of bales in this shot. But I don't know if I could have told you the difference before this week. I spent the week watching them bring in all of this straw and hay from the fields. And it's a pretty simple difference. Hay is feed for animals. They grow an entire field just of hay. It's grass and alfalfa and things like that. They don't let the animals graze it. And they cut it, dry it, bale it up, and this is what the cattle eat all winter. Whereas straw, this just came from some farmer's barley field after the combines had gone through it. It doesn't have any nutritional value because the seeds are all gone. But it's still useful for things like bedding and keeping things clean. So they have both. I think they have about 400 bales of hay back there, maybe 300 of these straw bales, and more to come. That's only about half to a third of what they'll use in the winter. So pretty simple difference, but I don't know. Did you know the difference between straw and hay? Anyway, I'll keep sharing my learning next week. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel and see what I'm learning. Or if you're interested in the documentary I'm making is called The Hands That Feed Us, and you can visit thehandsthatfeedus.ca and sign up for the mailing list. Or you can follow my journey on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you next week.